generation, maybe we think about war, swords, violence, but ushering in a revolution does not have to include violence. It doesn't have to include any of those characteristics. A revolutionary can use peace and nonviolence to bring about change, serving as an activist, campaigning to bring about social and political change specifically. Dave Swanson, our next speaker, won the open mic night for TEDx Charlottesville. In addition to being an activist, he is a radio host, an author, a journalist, and he serves as the director of the World Beyond War, an organization with a mission to end war and establish just and sustainable peace through nonviolent means. A revolutionary, if you will. Everyone, please welcome David Swanson.
Raise your hand if you're open to changing your mind about important things. Now raise your hand if you think war is never justified. Some hands I think not raised, possibly because war culture is never questioned. Every person I've spoken to outside of Charlottesville who I've asked has had no idea that the reason a statue of Robert E. Lee is still standing in this town, albeit covered in black plastic, is because a Virginia state law bans the removal of war monuments. And I have never met anyone, anywhere, who has even considered the idea of banning the removal of peace monuments. The hardest part would be finding a peace monument to remove. If we removed only the racist war monuments in Charlottesville, we would lose Lee, Jackson, the generic Confederate, the people who helped slaughter Native Americans, the memorial to the war that killed 3.8 million Vietnamese, although Vietnamese was not usually the word used to refer to them, and UVA's World War I monument, a war explicitly marketed as a war on the evil race of Huns. In other words, we would lose all the war monuments, and I want to propose something harder than that, that we rid ourselves of war. The American Public Health Association calls militarism a public health threat. Gallup and Pew polling find majorities in countries around the world consider the U.S. government the top threat to peace on Earth. Why? Well, the U.S. spends about $1 trillion a year preparing for and fighting wars. Over half of discretionary spending, almost as much as the rest of the world combined, including all the U.S. allies the U.S. pushes to spend more. The six richest billionaires have the money of half the world, but they have less than half what the U.S. alone spends each and every year on war, 3% of which could end starvation on Earth. 1% could end the lack of clean drinking water. A larger fraction could give us a chance against climate change. War kills, and it kills even more through the disease epidemics and the famines it creates in places like Yemen, and most of all, through the diversion of resources from where they are needed. Totally destroy North Korea or totally restore Puerto Rico. It's a choice. War's victims are mostly civilians. War generates enemies. Terrorism has predictably increased throughout the war on terrorism. Nonviolence has proven itself a more effective tool. Talking with Iran and North Korea has worked. Sanctions and threats have not worked. Militarism is the top destroyer of our natural environment. It reduces jobs. It fuels a culture of violence. It erodes civil liberties. It militarizes our police. It gives Charlottesville a mine-resistant vehicle. Raise your hand if you have never stepped on a landmine in Charlottesville. War is not needed. Its presence is sporadic through history, virtually absent from prehistory. It's unrecognizable in its current form from just a few centuries back. It requires intense conditioning. Higher suicide rates result. And we have yet to discover a single case of PTSD from war deprivation. Since World War II, the U.S. military has bombed over 30 countries, killed or helped kill some 20 million people. The U.S. provides training or weapons to 3/4 of the world's dictatorships. Many wars now have U.S. weapons on both sides. We know we have a racism problem. Do we realize that we have a militarism problem too? Maybe we would if we had any monuments to anything else. What about a monument in Charlottesville to civil rights? What about one to labor or women's rights or the environment or art or education or music? What about a monument in Charlottesville to peace? When I say go, please raise your hand again if you think war is never justified, and also raise your hand if you think just maybe, just possibly, if I've been allowed more than 5 minutes, I might persuade you that war is never justified. In fact, raise your hand like this. Go. Thank you.